Alrighty folks, welcome back to Hardline 4x4. Today we are working on the budget truck, cheap truck build project. Today we're going to do a transmission filter, transmission pan, and transmission pan gasket. I'm going to show you how to do it and how to go about it safely and all that fun stuff. There's some things you should know before doing it. Other than that, let's get started. So first things first is you're going to want to pop off your pan. I already did it. It ain't too hard, it's just 14 bolts in a circular pattern here. I'm not going to reuse this pan because I want one with a drain plug. And I thought it was kind of weird that these didn't come with them. But oh well, I got a new one for 40 bucks from Napa. It's a Dorman pan. I'll put it down in the description so you guys can go pick one up if you'd like. This is for a 4R70W Ford transmission. My truck's got a small block, but they had these transmissions in I think 95 and up. But yeah, so if you're gonna get a new pan, the first thing you're gonna want to do is there's gonna be a magnet right there. Pop that thing off and clean the heck out of it. As you can see, I already got mine off and cleaned up. And then the second thing is you're gonna want to get a really good gasket and filter. Don't cheap out on it. I mean, the transmission is a pretty big deal. I got this rubber coated metal gasket and filter from obviously Napa, great parts. All right, now that we have our new pan and this magnet is all cleaned up, we're just gonna go ahead and stick that puppy right there. And then we'll get to that filter. All right, now we're under my pickup. I just tipped something over. What you're gonna wanna do is, your crossmember will probably look different than mine. I built my own because I'm solid axle swapping this truck in a couple of weeks. What you're gonna wanna do is just give this thing a little wiggle and it'll pop off. And then you just dunk it right into the pan here. Oops. Here's the new filter. I'm gonna try to get a little bit of the fluid on there so it'll pop up all nice like. And then yeah, you kind of just pop it up in there and it kind of sits where it sits. I don't know if I even am getting that on camera, but yeah, you just kind of give it a little. I just swirled it around in some fluid and then popped it up in there, and then you should be good to roll. And I might have called that a gasket, but that is your filter. And then you're good to put your pan on. And here's another thing I picked up before doing this. These are just, they call them valve cover clamps. But what they are is they are technically a valve cover spreader bar. So what they do is they just, you know, they distribute the weight when you put a bolt through them. So it doesn't, you know, when you put a bolt through a really thin pan, it's going to try to cup the actual pan with the bolt. When you're tightening it, it's going to try to cup it, and then you're going to have a leak. So these will help distribute the weight a little better. I'm gonna throw them in every other hole because there's only 8 of them and I was not about to buy another pack of them. So we're gonna give these things a shot and see how they do. But let's get that pan put up. These bolts all up there, and I've got the spreaders on them placed throughout every other bolt. Torque spec on these is I believe it's 16, but I'm gonna start at 12 and see how that feels. Just gonna see what Yeah, I definitely think that I could probably go a little bit more. Yeah, especially with this extension on, it's gonna kind of make it all wacky. I'm just gonna torque all these in a crisscross pattern because that's how they ask you to do it. I'm may take a, ooh, shit, my head. May take a minute, but I fought this thing earlier trying to get it to seal and it would not. And that's because I bought a cheap gasket and this pan is kind of shit. So I'm going to do my final torque in a circle, and I'm going to do it at 20 foot-pounds. Spec is 16, but I don't really want this thing coming loose, and these spreader bolts are kind of keeping it from bowing, and you don't want your pan to cup at all. So if you see that pan cupping, I recommend that you check it out and definitely make sure that you keep an eye on them spots once you put fluid in it, because you know, fluid's about $12 a quart for Dex Merc here in Minnesota, depending on where you're from. So definitely not cheap, and you're not going to want to put it in your transmission after it's been through, you know, a couple funnels and all that stuff. So. But I think it is good to roll. I'm going to check the drain plug and make sure that that is tight, because I've loosened it already once. And then we're going to put fluid in it and see if it holds this time. And we'll do the gear cycle and all that fun stuff. Alrighty, folks. I got it running again. I overfilled the living shit out of the transmission because I wasn't paying attention. It says it takes 14 quarts. I only put like 11 in. It made a mess out of the shop, but that's all right. Now we just gotta hop in here. And we're just gonna do a gear cycle. So I'm gonna put it in reverse. We'll go to neutral. We're gonna have to do this a little bit. I'm not gonna show it all. It's already trying to move, so I'm gonna keep doing this for just a couple of cycles, and then we'll take her for a drive.
Alrighty, folks, so it's been a little while. I forgot to post that video getting the transmission pan done. It wasn't the transmission pan leaking, it was actually my extension housing for my transfer case to my transmission. But as you can see, we're driving it. I'm doing 78 miles an hour. My gauge is off. But it's running driving good. Transmission's still not good, but it runs the drive still.
I've done a couple things since the last video I took. As you can see, you know, there's some color added in the truck. But the front axle, I finally solid axle swapped it, so there's a video coming up on that soon. This thing drives pretty good for a swap. I built all the suspension for on my own.
But there's a lot more to come on the channel. My fiance, she's actually behind me somewhere in the car. She picked up a 93 F-150 single cab long box 5.0. We've got some 36 inch super swappers we're going to put on it. It's going to keep the GGB front suspension for now. And we're going to turn it into kind of a trail truck, daily driver, kind of like this truck, where I can drive it on the highway and take it off road as well. Probably won't weld the diff right away or lock the diff in the rear like I did on this one, but only time will tell. But more coming up. Stay tuned. Make sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Thank y'all.